Hi friends, welcome to EPG Patashala Lessons in Public Administration. Today's lesson is on public policy and the main contributions of Drawer and Laswell. Both of them are noted contributors on public policy. What is a public policy? Before I tell you what is a public policy, let me introduce myself. I am Professor Panjala Narasaya, retired professor of public administration from Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Open University, Hyderabad. Friends, government does many things, does not do many things. Whatever the government does is known as a public policy. It is known as a public policy because that policy is framed in the interest of the public. Sometimes government does not take a decision. That is also public policy. Maybe because by banning, say, a particular thing, that may be helpful to the people. So that is a decision. By introducing a particular thing, maybe in the interest of the public, that is also a public policy. So whatever the government does or does not do comes under the bracket of public policy. And government is there to take decisions. And those decisions are known as public policies. Policies which are taken in the interest of the public, in public interest otherwise. It was realized that public policies need a separate treatment. Hence, thinkers like Drawer, Laswell, and others made a study of formulation, implementation, evaluation of public policies so that there can be some scientific approach to the public policy formulation. In this lesson on the contributions of Drawer and Laswell, we know more about their contributions to public policy development.
Harold Dwight Laswell was born in 1902 and expired in 1978. He was a political scientist who had contributed to the fields of communication theory and policy sciences. He did his PhD from the University of Chicago and was a professor of law at Yale University. He was a multidisciplinarian and a behavioralist. He was the president of the American Political Science Association, APSA, as well as of the World Academy of Art and Science, WAAS. Harold Laswell had a vision for the policy sciences. He envisaged that policy sciences would confluence both social sciences and practical policy making to solve public problems. The concept of the problem orientation was developed by Laswell, and this still is relevant to the scholarly field of policy analysis. Laswell's ideas are used by many writers, past and present, to understand the conceptual framework of policy sciences and analysis. Policy Sciences, one of the first and important journals to be published in the area of policy sciences, was founded by Laswell. He believed that problem orientation should be the focus of the policy sciences. His major contribution was in the form of the book, The Policy Sciences, edited jointly with Daniel Lerner and first published by the Standard University Press in 1951. Laswell on public policy, what does he say on that? Laswell is considered as an eminent scholar in the field of public policy because of the following reasons. Number one, he attempted to integrate the methods of sciences into policy making and formalized the relationship between social science and policy making. Number two, he emphasized policy analysis as based in policy orientation and problem solving. The problem solving approach he advocated was criticized due to its presumptions like inadequate, univocal definition of social problems, and in the process excludes different policy meanings and does not deal with political agenda setting. In general, the problem-solving view of policy science has been debunked as a myth. However, many researchers have drawn the problem-solving approach he advocated was criticized due to its presumptions like inadequate, univocal definition of social problems, and in the process excludes different policy meanings, and does not deal with political agenda setting. In general, the problem-solving view of policy science has been debunked as a myth. However, many researchers have drawn on alternative epistemological perspectives, which are different from political science. But policy scientists have also acknowledged that the values of democracy, which was central to Laswell's idea, and adopted his belief that scholars should be concerned with policy making in practice rather than in abstract theory. The first part of this module will examine Laswell's idea of policy sciences as a science and his concept of problem orientation as core of policy sciences. Laswell considered the question of how to relate science and politics and what this means for conception of policy analysis as a field of scholarly inquiry. Laswell's problem can be viewed as understanding the scientific approach in a new way and also see how to retain the problem concept and extract it from its scientific connotations. To consider Laswell in a different way will help us assess his ideas for contemporary interpretative policy analysis. Charles E. Rothwell, writing in the foreword to the Policy Sciences, says that the formulation and execution of policy usually consists of four steps: a clarification of goals, an exhaustive evaluation of the situation to be met, the selection of a course of action by weighing the probable consequences of various alternatives, and the determination of optimum means for carrying out the action decided upon. He goes on to add that the sciences of society are essential to the formulation and application of policy at every stage. According to Laswell, the development of policy orientation has been a twofold process, one directed towards the policy process and the other towards the intelligence needs of policy. Policy orientation is focused upon the scientific study of policy. The needs of policy intelligence are uppermost. Any item of knowledge, within or without the limits of social disciplines, may be relevant. Therefore, the emphasis of Laswell on scientific methods to acquire information relevant to policy intelligence is what policy orientation is all about, and this in turn forms the basis of policy making. To Laswell, this represents a movement not only towards policy orientation but also towards policy sciences of democracy. The added emphasis to democracy is to recognize the pushes and pulls of competing groups in democratic societies for favorable decisions or policies from governments. This is not to suggest that in non-democratic systems, pushes and pulls do not exist, but the freedom to mobilize and express demands through pushes and pulls is noticeably absent. Policy approach focuses on the fundamental problems of humanity rather than on topical issues of the moment. Policy approach focuses on the fundamental problems of humanity rather than on topical issues of the moment. This does, while answering the question, knowledge for what, raised by Professor Robert S. Lind, Laswell insists on the importance of acquiring and utilizing all available knowledge to cope with the crisis of our times. He states that the difficulties in managing and operating economic and political institutions can be overcome only by application of scientific methods to a multidisciplinary area like policy sciences. Laswell also talks about the role of creative imagination in policy orientation. To achieve the purpose of policy orientation, building of institutions that observe, evaluate, and reconstruct practices of society are necessary to protect procedures to assist in policy process. Hence, Laswell says that the policy sciences approach also includes, in addition to the knowledge about the policy making process, the evaluation of such knowledge that has bearing on policy problems. In short, Laswell's idea of policy orientation has the following features: objectivity in gathering and interpretation of data, choice of problems that will contribute to the goal values, use of scrupulous objectivity and maximum technical ingenuity in execution of the project undertaken. Laswell and Lerner's edited volume has contributions from leading social scientists including Edward Schells, Margaret Mead, Kenneth Arrow, Paul Lazarsfeld, Herbert Hyman, Renset Leckert, Robert Metten, etc., and deals with inputs from case studies and methods. This in itself is a reflection of Laswell's approach to problem orientation in policy sciences. A detailed discussion on the area can be had from Nick Turnbull's Harold Laswell's Problem Orientation for the Policy Sciences. To conclude, if Laswell gave direction and framework for policy sciences, it was Hegel Drawer who took forward his idea to develop models for policy sciences. You will now be familiarized to select ideas of Drawer. It needs to be mentioned here that you are already familiar with Drawer as an administrative thinker in the course on administrative thinkers. Drawer. Hegel Drawer is Professor Emeritus of Political Science and Public Administration at the Hebrew University of Jerusalem. His approach to policy making was to break the distinction between politics and administration and stated that policy making activity and its execution were related and complemented to each other. In this lesson, we will discuss some of the major contributions of Drawer and its similarities with the policy orientation concept of Laswell. Drawer's major books in English include Israel, High Pressure Planning, 1966, Public Policy Making Re-Examined, 1968, Ventures in Policy Sciences, 1971, Design for Policy Sciences, 1971, Crazy States, A Counter-Conventional Strategic Issue, 1971, Policy Making Under Adversity, 1986, The Capacity to Govern, A Report to the Club of Rome, 2001, Israel Statecraft, National Security Challenges and Responses, 2012, Avant-Garde Politician, Readers for a New Epoch, 2014, and many writings in Hebrew. Drawer's assumptions on policy sciences, which he terms as euphoristic laws, states that while the difficulties and dangers of problems tend to increase at a geometric rate, the number of persons qualified to deal with these problems tends to increase at an arithmetic rate. While human capacities to shape the environment, society, and human beings are rapidly increasing, policy-making capabilities to use those remain the same. This view is similar to the one expressed by Laswell about two decades earlier in 1951 on the problems facing the society. Thus, Drawer provides a framework of policy making that can be scientific, objective, and rational, but not devoid of normative features. In this context, he explains that though science and its frontiers have expanded our understanding of mankind and to put to use the benefits of science to the welfare of humanity is still primitive. Some of the concepts of Drawer include mega meta policy, alternative futures, future studies, meta control, meta decision, meta evaluation, policy instruments and its settings, primary and secondary uncertainty, political feasibility and leverage, sub-optimization, tacit knowledge and theory, and ultra stability. The concepts and its application have become fundamental to policy making and analysis in contemporary times. Mega policy refers to overall goals, assumptions on futures, risk evaluation, degrees of innovation, etc., for a set of discrete policies. These can be explained as policies pertaining to specific sectors like health, education, energy, industry, etc. Meta policy deals with the policy on policy making systems and institutions, that is, policy on the nature and characteristics of policy making systems. As much as mega policies are core to governance, meta policies focus on the institutional mechanisms involved in the policy process, similar to the erstwhile Planning Commission and the Niti Aayog Policy Commission India. Future studies and its alternatives deal with futuristic projections in many areas or sectors that have a probability of realization in a given time frame. Meta controls decisions and evaluation are those relating to control of the control systems, decisions about the features of the decision-making system, and evaluation of the evaluating systems. Drawer, in advocating the concepts, believes that governance of contemporary society should not only have effective policies and institutions for achieving the goals, but also have supra-institutional mechanisms to exercise watchdog-like functions over the mega-policy process. In India, such institutions or processes are in vogue in the form of Lokpal, RTI, the proposed Judicial Accountability Bill, etc. The objective of such mechanisms is to ensure accountability and exercise self-evaluation and control methods to their functions. Policy instruments, according to Drawer, are multiple factors or variables that have a bearing on policy formulation process. Variables can be reset according to desired outcomes. Resetting of variables should not be confused with increment changes, but is connected to modification of policy instruments that are necessary to achieve the goals. Factors are dynamic, particularly in mega policy or sector policy scenario, and hence need to be re-examined in changing settings. Primary uncertainty is a condition when results or consequences are unknown, and secondary uncertainty is when consequences are known, but the scope is not known. Robert Merton calls it as anticipated and unanticipated consequences. It is risk evaluation of policy outcomes. Drawer's criticism of incremental approach is based on risk avoidance, which he says as running away from the problem arena. Political feasibility and leverage refers to the policy alternatives that are politically feasible for implementation, and also the extent to which political support for a policy initiative is available. Leverage. Many policy decisions are political, and therefore successful and effective implementation of policies depends to a great extent on the political support in a democracy. The space for effective political action needs to be assessed while evaluating the feasibility. Needless to say that competitive policies in a democracy requires compromise on different factors that go into the framing of policies, including financial allocation. You may refer to Theodore Lowy's discussion on interest groups and governmental policies for more information. Ultra stability as a concept refers to the stability of governing laws and institutions that are part of the policy making systems. A stable system enforces predictability and provides a strong platform for policy formulation. To conclude, Drawer, in dealing with these concepts, provides an operational approach To draw in dealing with these concepts provides an operational approach to policy sciences. Subsequent developments in policy studies and methods for policy analysis have expanded the scope of policy sciences, many by critical evaluation and or by adopting the framework of the contributions of Laswell and Rohr.
Friends, till now, we had a discussion on the contributions of Laswell and Rohr to the development of public policy sciences. Both of them are regarded as eminent contributors to the development of public policy sciences. Laswell argued that a public policy should be problem-oriented. It means that a policy decision should find a solution to the existing problems of the people so that people can have a happy life. That is actually the duty of the government of the day also. Rohr, while agreeing with Laswell, argues that enough care should be taken to collect data based on scientific approach to formulate public policy. Policy formulation, implementation, evaluation need scientific data bank. Thus, both of them are in agreement with each other that there is a need to solve the problems of people through public policy. Today, both of them are relevant to the study of public policies. Thank you. Thank you very much.